Roy Yarbrough beat Charlie Glotzbeck on the last lap in 1969.
Look at Bobby Labonte coming up on the outside by himself. He got a little help from Jimmy Spencer.
Oh, Jimmy Spencer. Spencer bounces off the wall, keeps on trucking. Two laps to go.
Big time hit by Spencer, but I told you Bobby Labonte was moving just a little while ago. What a muscle move on the outside. Fastest qualifier here for the 500, showing his muscle now.
Three makes in the 500, Chevy, Pontiac, Ford, that's how they run. But Earnhardt has a benefit. There's a slow car up ahead.
And there's trouble coming off of turn two. Some cars get strangled. It might be this. Whoever gets back to the start-finish line, they'll get the white and the yellow together.
Lake Speed and John Andretti tangle as the leaders head for turn number three. Andretti and Spencer got together.
This could be the Daytona 500. Bobby Labonte goes to the outside.
Labonte up high. Earnhardt uses the left car of Rick Bass as a pick. 20 years of trying, 20 years of frustration. Dale Earnhardt will come to the caution flag to win the Daytona 500. Finally, the most anticipated moment in racing. If John Elway can win the Super Bowl, Dale Earnhardt said he could win the Daytona 500. And if he comes around under caution to complete this final lap, the taste of long-awaited victory will be his.
Wow, what a drive by Dale Earnhardt, doing everything he had to do today.
And Bobby Labonte saying, boy, I needed that last lap.
At the top of the show, you saw the steely eyes of Dale Earnhardt. I'll bet they'll be tearful when he pulls into victory lane.
Let me tell you, it'll make the strongest man on earth cry when you win this race. It's special.
Bobby Labonte comes across the line to the caution flag in second. Jeremy Mayfield's Ford third. Kenny Schrader with a shot at that $2 million bonus, as did Bobby Labonte. Checkered flag. Dale Earnhardt finally is a champion of the Daytona 500. Larry McReynolds, for the second time in this great race, will go to victory lane, once with the late Davey Allison and today with Earnhardt. The run to the caution flag from turn three.
He came up on Rick Mast. Rick Mast moved to the inside, and that's all Earnhardt needed, buddy, was just some racetrack up there to run on.
Yeah, you can see Bobby Labonte and Mayfield hitting as they come down towards the tri-oval. Mayfield, not quite.
There's the crew, Larry McReynolds and his team. Looking at Earnhardt, big hug from Richard Childress, the car owner.
What a chance to win the eighth championship. Momentum.
Richard Childress, you have tried so hard, so long, you have done it. What is it like to finally win the Daytona 500?
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. You know, this team this year, we took all winter, and I can't say enough about Dale Earnhardt, GM Goodrich, who stood behind, and most of all, our race fans. Unbelievable.
And there are people in this victory area that are in tears.
They used to boo Dale Earnhardt when he was winning too much. That'll happen if you dominate any sport. But today, when they introduced the Intimidator, the crowd was full of cheers. I think everyone, if their favorite driver couldn't win the Daytona 500, they wanted to see this man drive to victory lane.
You pull up for the check of the spoiler. One of the NASCAR officials crawls underneath the car.
71st career Winston Cup victory for the second generation driver and seven-time national champion. He said it'd make a big man cry. Here's Chocolate Myers of Earnhardt's crew.
Well, it don't get any bigger. But I tell you what, I feel about the same way.
Look out on pit road. Every man on every crew has come out to the edge of pit lane to congratulate the man who has dominated everything there is to win in this sport, except this race, until today.
That's great. There was Todd Jarrett, Dale Jarrett's crew chief, other members, other team members of other...
Andy Petrie was there. And This will be the longest receiving line in the history of celebrations.
Wow. Yep, I've never seen that, Mike. Not that many. You know, normally we'll see two or three or four teams come out there, but this is something.
Dad, I was going to say the same thing. I had about 10 teams come out when I won this one, but look at this. Everybody knows what it means to the man that's done everything to finally get the Daytona 500.
There's Derek Culp, or rather Ernie Irvin's crew. There's NASCAR officials out there. There's Robert Presley's crew, Ricky Craven's team.
NASCAR officials.
He's shaking everybody's hand, too, if you notice.
59 races since he's been to Victory Lane. 19 Daytona 500s. Twice, he led at the white flag and failed to take the checker in first place. But today belongs to the man who grew up at the corner of Coach and Sedan Street in Kannapolis, North Carolina, a mill town north of Charlotte, where he worked underneath that house in a garage on his own race cars and those of his father to become one of NASCAR's two greatest champions. He and Richard Petty, the only two drivers with seven Winston Cups on their trophy shelf.
Mike, he's a long way from Victory Circle yet, and the crowd's building.
And Earnhardt, along with Bobby Labonte, Jeremy Mayfield, Rusty Wallace, and again, Ken Schrader, will have a shot at that R.J. Reynolds million-dollar bonus when they post it next time later this season. Last year at Darlington, South Carolina, some question Earnhardt's ability to go 500 miles when he blanked out on the first lap at Darlington, South Carolina, and had to climb from the car and go to the care center.
Watch this circle. He's going to spin out.
There goes the grass.
Yeah. Goodbye.
A smoke show. The fellow who drives his Craftsman truck, Ron Hornaday, likes to do when he celebrates a victory. And now, look at that throng. Can he get to Victory Lane from here?
He's going to have a lot of help from a lot of security people
Come
to get
on,
there,
guys.
It looks like.
I want to hear what he has to say.
Don't worry. He's won at this racetrack 30 times. He, better than anyone, knows the way to Victory Lane. The most anticipated moment in the history of NASCAR racing. Dale Earnhardt rolling into Victory Lane in the Daytona 500. Awaiting Dale Earnhardt is the man who brought the Daytona 500 to CBS, Ken Squier.
The 20-year quest is over. Gates have just opened for Dale Earnhardt in Victory Lane at Daytona. Here's his wife, Teresa, coming to speak to him. One for Dale Earnhardt. Perhaps one for Neil Bonnett as well. About to ratchet himself out of this beautifully prepared car. He said patience was what it was going to take, and patience is what he gave it. All right, getting on the hat. He's waiting on this, and he's ready to clamber out, ready to step out of car number three, the winner of the Daytona 500. Oh, gonna have a drink of soda here. It's been a long time before refreshment here. All right, here he comes out of his car, and listen to this. Two decades he's waited for this moment, and it's here, and everybody gets a bath. Dale.
Yes.
What a show.
Yes.
Here with Larry McReynolds, and a big hug. And Richard
years.
Childress. Dale, how about that ride?
How about it?
Man, can you believe it? For one, got an awesome race car, but for two, thank good Lord for a good day. This race car did everything. The good Lord looked after it all day long. Good wrench. This is for all them race fans and all them people who have been saying, Dale, this is your year. Dale, this is your year. And boy, a lot of them said it this year, all the way from Mr. France all the way down to Todd Parrott and all the guys on the team. The Daytona 500 is ours. We've won it. We've won it. We've won it.
And everybody took a shot at you at the end.
I don't care who was taking shots at me. I was driving the mirror more than was the front. But, you know, I tell you, these great sponsors, these great people that's worked with us and give us everything we need to win with. This is a good race car. The Spinny Clinton. Hey, David, congratulations on your baby. And Larry McReynolds, Spinny Clinton, Richard Childress. We got one heck of a race team. We're going to win a championship this year.
One for Dale and one for Teresa, one for Neil Bonnet, two today.
Well, one for a lot of people, T. Wayne Robinson and, you know, all Neil Bonnet, my dad, everybody that's been in racing has been my friend that taught me so much, that touched my life. There's so many of them, I can't thank them all. My mom, thank you, Mom. I know she's back home. Dale Jr., hope you're not too sore. Carrie and Kelly, I love y'all.
You've touched a lot of people here today, and we'll be back for the trophy presentation in a moment after these messages.
You the man. You a bad man. Good job.
You next.
Good job, buddy.
Congratulations.
So what are we going to do tomorrow?
Saturday! The new redesigned Ford Ranger. The only compact pickup built Ford tough.
In our quest for the finest brakes in the world, we tested our pads against other leading brands. With pad after pad. In test after test. The results were always the same. No other brand stopped shorter than Performance Friction Carbon Metallic. The ones we stock at AutoZone.
It's good to know that in an era of superstars, big corporate sponsorships, and network TV deals, there's an organization that also cares about fairness and sportsmanship, that realizes its fans are the sole reason for its success. It knows it should never go so fast that it can't slow down if there's a good enough reason. This is NASCAR, and this is the way we've done things for 50 years.
Now there's a tire that can survive even this. The Goodyear Eagle F1 Run Flat. Even with no air pressure, Goodyear Run Flat technology lets you drive up to 50 miles at 55 miles per hour to safety, so you won't get stuck with a flat. Serious technology, freedom from worry. Eagle F1 Run Flat.
Serious freedom.
Only from Goodyear.
Goodyear, Goodyear.
Well, we're back here in Victory Lane. John Graham, president of the Daytona International Speedway, after perhaps the greatest 500 of them all, is about to make the presentation to Dale Earnhardt, symbol of victory in the great American race. John?
Ken?
Dale, can we get you up here for a second?
Dale, congratulations. Here is a replica of the Harley J. Earl Trophy, symbolic of the champion of the Daytona 500, and we'll inscribe your name on the permanent Harley J. Earl Trophy on display along with your winning car in Daytona, USA, year-round. Congratulations. A great day for
racing. Yes. Somebody may get hurt here.
Great day for racing.
I tell you, it's a great day, and I was wondering if I'd ever get my name on that trophy when y'all built that thing. And it's going to be great to have this in my trophy case, but it's for Richard Childress and all the guys. Everybody worked so hard for this. There's too many people in my life I had to think I couldn't think of all right now.
Dale. You lose that car for a whole year. It's going to be at Daytona, USA. They'll roll it in tonight.
That's why I took it out in the grass and spun around a little bit. I knew I wasn't going to race there again. I just thought I'd throw a little grass up.
Very well planned. Those pit stops were just immaculate today.
Well, they were. The guys did a great job, and Dale didn't choke it on a pit road, so everything worked great. And, I can't say enough for this team, I tell you. We've had so many people that really worked so hard for Jim Goodrich Service. They have been, you know, supportive all the way through. Here we are in victory lane again. I knew we could do it.
And you did it, and you did it in style. Let's go to Dick Berggren.
I'm with Bobby Labonte, who put on a terrific run at the end to finish second, his best ever in the Daytona 500. Where did all that speed come from at the end of the day?
Man, you know, Jimmy Spencer really helped me out a lot all day, all week long, and our cars worked really good together. And, you know, he's kind of out there. I've got a few guys to work with, but we worked good together all week and, you know, brought this Interstate Pontiac, you know, put me back up there and from about seventh back to second there with about three laps to go. So it was a pretty awesome run for us.
And the little guy is Tyler Labonte. Ralph?
Jeremy Mayfield, a tremendous run for you. Tell me about that last lap.
Man, I'm glad it's over with. You know, had a really strong car. The Mobile One Ford was just outstanding all day. Didn't make any adjustments. The pit stops were great. My teammate, great. I mean, we worked together good all day, and that's shows a class act between both teams. We both ran good together and helped each other, and, you know, everybody started shuffling around at the end and really didn't have a chance to make a run on him, but, you know, we gave it our best shot.
Your new teammate, Rusty Wallace, was the first one over to congratulate you. Is this teammate thing really going to work out? What'd he say to you?
Man, just thumbs up. You know, Rusty's a great guy. We've become really good friends. We're here to help each other. You know, the 2 and the 12 cars aren't going to race each other. We're here to help each other, and that showed today. You know, Rusty, man, what a guy. You know, he's won everything there is to win, and having him in your corner means a lot.
This could be a new powerful force. Jeremy Mayfield and Rusty Wallace in Winston Cup Racing, Ken.
Ralph, you're done, yeah.
Victory Lane, that's the place to be. That's where Earnhardt is after 20 years of trying here in the Great American Race. We'll be back with more of the story after this.
In racing, the engine is everything.
What? It's the driver.
A driver will never see a finish line without a great engine.
The greatest engine will never see a victory lap without a great driver.
At least they agree on Haviland Formula 3 motor oil, the same oil you can buy right off the shelf. And also try Haviland Extended Life Antifreeze.
The engine's the first thing with the finish line.
Not in IndyCars.
Where does NAPA keep over 200,000 different parts? Right up here. Now remember, your belt tension on this is critical. What kind of car is it?
Well, I'll sell you all the struts you want, but I wouldn't recommend putting them in without the right tools.
I'm sure we have it. Okay, is it a 77 or a 78? Because they changed the carburetor in 78.
Actually, that's not a stupid question at all. I know what it used to be.
You don't stay at NAPA long handing out the wrong answers, and I'm not planning on going anywhere.
Keep America running.
If you've been getting those phone stickers, you may be getting a little confused. So allow me to simplify.
I love stickers.
Okay, but if you're calling anywhere in America or anywhere around the world, most calls from home will cost you less with AT&T One Rate and One Rate International.
So you're saying the sticker...
I'm saying if you use those stickers, you could get a little sticky. You might get stuck paying more with those stickers.
Yeah, I know, I got that. But I love stickers.
Never been more frightened in my life.
In America and around the world, the AT&T One Rate plans.
Let's start with the brewmaster for just a moment. The brewmaster is the chef. That is the key brewmaster role, to understand the blending of his or her ingredients. Not only he or she tastes the beer every day, there's another person who tastes the beer every day, and that is me. The ability to have hands-on brewmasters working with the finest ingredients gives you Budweiser.
The 500 is concluded, but the racing action is not. CBS Sportsline brings you all the latest news from Daytona with exclusive columns, interviews, driver bios, and more at cbs.sportsline.com. Next, snowboarding and bobsledding from Nagano, the 18th Winter Olympics on CBS. And tonight, 60 minutes, followed by continuing coverage of the Olympic Winter Games, ice dancing, two-man bobsleds, and men's speed skating. If you were a bumper sticker on the back of Dale Earnhardt's car, here's what you would have seen. Dale Earnhardt came in it today, having never led lap 96, 97, 98 of the Daytona 500, but finally He has led lap 200, the final lap. What ended the race under caution? Let's have a look here.
There's Jimmy Spencer, number 23. John Andretti comes up quickly on him. Has to look like he just had to lock his brakes and cut to the left. That Lake spins it around. Lake Speed in car number 9 goes around as well.
Looking down the backstretch toward turn 2. And let's join Dick Berggren.
With Kenny Schrader in what has got to be one of the gutsiest runs we've ever seen here in the Daytona 500. Kenny, how are you?
I'm okay. I knew I'd be okay. I wore my Kenny Wallace shirt today.
And ice packs, and what is this yellow thing?
That's a TENS unit. It just shocks. Ooh, it shocks you bad enough that you forget about what hurts. But we had it on, and we had a Copenhagen Bull Rider vest on, and we had a arthroplasty on, and we were geared up for the crash, and it never happened.
What are you going to be like tomorrow?
I'll be a lot happier.
Well, it's not $1 million, Ken Squier, Mike Joy, but Ken Schrader has done a great job today to finish fifth.
Well, he's eligible for that next $1 million bonus as well by finishing in the top 5. Unofficial finish. Earnhardt, Bobby Labonte, Jeremy Mayfield, Kenny Schrader, Rusty Wallace, Ernie Irvin finishes in 6th. Chad Little, a fine run to 7th. Mike Skinner to 8th. Michael Waltrip, 9th. Two-time winner Bill Elliott was 10th. Kyle Petty, 11th. And Bobby Hamilton, 12th. 13th, Terry Labonte, the outside pole sitter, and Ricky Craven. Jimmy Spencer, Jeff Gordon, Lake Speed, and John Andretti, the lead lap cars. Kenny Irwin, the rookie, a lap down. Ted Musgrave, Jerry Nadeau, the rookie. Sterling Marlin, Mike Wallace, and Brett Bodine. Ward Burton, 25th, and Joe Nemechek, Dick Trickle, Steve Grissom, Andy Hillenberg, and Rick Mast in 30th. Jeff Bodine, former winner. Robert Presley, former champion Darrell Waltrip, and Dale Jarrett. Billy Standridge, the rookie, and Dave Marcus, the veteran. Then Derek Cope, Mark Martin, and Greg Sachs, the last man running. In the garage were Jeff Burton, rookie Steve Park, Ricky Rudd, and rookie Kevin LePage. CBS sports coverage of the Daytona 500 will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
Ford Explorer, when no town's big enough for the both of you.
March Madness is on CBS.
They may be spread out all over the Southeast, but they've got plenty in common. Building their businesses, always on the go. And they've all got the Southern Link digital wireless network with Instant Link, which lets them push just one button and talk with one person or an entire work group. Plus, they can have phone service and paging. Everything in just one Motorola handset. Shouldn't your company look into getting linked too? Southern Link from Southern Company.
Oh, that's great.
Okay.
Hey, look, the race is on.
Lowe's Home Improvement Warehouse is proud to sponsor Richard Childress and Mike Skinner in the Team Lowe's number 31. So if you're into home improvement and love racing, we're going to do everything we can to put you right in the middle of the action.
Dad, nice job.
Now that was a costly mistake.
Lowe's, the official home improvement warehouse of NASCAR.
This is the Chevy S10. Not just any old S10, but one with aluminum wheels, a great stereo, and air conditioning. This is what Consumers Digest thinks of the S10. This is how to make a best buy even better. Just $169 a month and zero down gets you a 36-month smart lease on an impressively equipped 4-cylinder S10. Just $169 total due at lease signing. And this is the catch. Hey, what else did you expect? Get to your Chevy dealer and get a smart lease on a Chevy S10.
Channel 5, your home for the 1998 Winter Olympic Games.
50th anniversary, CBS sports coverage of the Daytona 500 is sponsored by Brewery Fresh Budweiser, the official beer of NASCAR. Hey, race fans, this Bud's for you. Goodyear, innovators of front flat technology. And by Texaco, a world of energy.
A huge crowd here at Daytona. numbed, smiling as this man wins his first Daytona 500. Here's Ralph Shaheen.
Well, Rusty Wallace, this is the best you've run at Daytona, your first top 10 finish here. How much is that is due to your new teammate, Jeremy Mayfield?
I think a lot of it's due to the newest thing we put together. We started developing the Taurus a long time ago. A long time ago, maybe about 6 months. And we've been really working hard on that car. But the engine ran great today, and the car handled perfect. And Jeremy and I really were working together perfect all day long. We were in the top five all day, top two, three mostly all day long. And it just felt really good to get a good top five run out of it. For a while there, I thought that maybe I might be able to win it. We had a really good run going on Dale one time, but man, we might have got to him, but it wasn't no getting around him. He wanted his Daytona 500 win really bad, and he deserved it, and I'm proud of him. But I just can't say enough about our new team. The Kranefis Penske team, the Penske South team, both guys worked great together. The cars were identical. Well, you know, when we came down here, they should have been real close to identical, and it worked out good.
Dick Berggren.
Ernie Irvin with an incredibly strong day today with the MB2 team. Were you at all surprised at the quality of that race car?
No, I really wasn't. You know, the Skittles Pontiac is a really good car, and they built last year, built this team, and, you know, the Pontiacs are an awesome car, and, you know, I'm just glad that, you know, we got a good run in, and, you know, Kim wasn't being able to be here because she had the baby on Monday, and Jordan's probably watching. Hey, Jordan, I love you, and I'll be home in a little bit, and we miss Jared.
Kim is the wife. Jordan and Jared are the children. What now? What do you expect for 1998?
I'm just going to keep building on it. Just keep getting good runs in every week. And, you know, this is a lot better start than I had last year. And we're just going to keep building on it.
Congratulations on a great run. Mike Joy.
Dick, a number of firsts this season. First win for Dale Earnhardt. And for the first time, a live Winston Cup race under the lights on network television. You'll see the Pepsi 400 here on CBS Saturday night, July 4th.
There we go. Off and running.
Earlier this week, Bill France lit up the Musco lighting around the outside of this speedway, and a man who's been coming here for 20 years came out to take 20 laps. Now, the lighting system's not completed, but they wired this driver to talk to the lighting people and tell them what he saw. Dale Earnhardt, first man under the lights at Daytona.
First time I came to Daytona and seen the racetrack in 1976, I was like, wow, how big this thing is. When I ran under the lights the other night, that was pretty impressive. Piece of history there.
You'll see the Pepsi 400 live in prime time here on CBS Saturday, July 4th. We can't wait. More from Daytona after this.
Now there's a tire that can survive even this. The Goodyear Eagle F1 Run Flat. Even with no air pressure, Goodyear Run Flat technology lets you drive up to 50 miles at 55 miles per hour to safety, so you won't get stuck with a flat. Serious technology, freedom from worry. Eagle F1 Run Flat.
Serious freedom.
Only from Goodyear.
Goodyear, Goodyear.
This is NASCAR. This is you. And this is us. Hot Wheels Pro Racing will get you this close to the action with Hot Wheels Pro Racing Diecast, the best of NASCAR in three scales. The Legend Series, unsurpassed detail in 64th scale. And Legends to Life, with real racing motion and digital sound. If they drive it, we make it. On the track, off the track, in the pits. Investment quality collectibles. Because to get them right on this scale, you got to race them on this one. We're Hot Wheels.
Competition won't be able to explain when the only four-door rookie in NASCAR starts blowing their doors off. Maybe they should get more doors. Ford Taurus.
They are guardian angels on wheels. Knights in shining armor who ride like the wind. And when lives are at stake, they are the cavalry that always comes through. That's why Texaco tests and retests clean system 3 gasoline under extreme emergency conditions. For all our heroes, for all of us, Texaco, a world of energy.
This CBS Sports Race Summary is sponsored by Texaco, a world of energy.
Back with you at Daytona. 200 laps in the books. The 200 that count for the 500. Eight leaders, but the leader they're all going to be talking about is Dale Earnhardt, victorious in this wonderful Daytona 500 today. Take a look at who did not make it to the end of the line. But consider that 43 started, and that's all that fell out. Amazing. Larry Woody, one of the great racing riders, writes for the Tennessean, has said, Dale doesn't drive for the dough. He drives for the sheer enjoyment of it. He chases checkers like a beagle chases rabbits. It's just his nature. My, wasn't his nature grand today, as he showed all the patience he needed to bring this event off. And that's what it takes to win the Daytona 500. Loads of patience. That was his point all week long, that he had to be patient and then go for it when the time came. And that's exactly the lesson he taught every short tracker in America this day in this 40th annual Daytona 500. We're going to take a commercial break and be back with you once again here at Daytona as the celebration continues. Win, win, win is what Earnhardt says. We're going for the championship this year.
Been a tradition since 1876. Think about that. That's more than 120 years ago that this company started making Budweiser under Adolphus Busch. The family has always put in the forefront, protect the excellence of the product Budweiser. And I think he would be very happy that the generations of his family have practiced what he taught us.
The problem with most home equity lenders is no equity means no loan. That's because they only let you borrow up to 80% of the value of your home. But at First Plus, you can borrow up to 125% of the value of your home. So even with no equity, you can still consolidate bills, make home improvements, or even get some extra cash. Just call 1-800-510-PLUS. You'll get an answer before you hang up. First Plus, no equity is no problem. So call 1-800-510-PLUS.
Wrangler jeans, available in the two colors boys prefer most, black and blue. Wrangler, real comfortable jeans.
Wrangler, the perfect jean for your 10-year-old son and your 10-year-old husband. Wrangler, real comfortable jeans.
In our quest for the finest brakes in the world, we tested our pads against other leading brands. With pad after pad, in test after test, the results were always the same. No other brand stopped shorter than Performance Friction Carbon Metallic, the ones we stock at AutoZone.
A 59 race drought comes to conclusion here in the greatest race of them all, the Daytona 500. Earnhardt reigns big time. Today, to that final moment, you witnessed a war between the finest 43 at Daytona. After each other with everything they had, they threw blocks, they scraped each other right down to the finish. And then when that checkered flag flew, as Earnhardt drove down pit road, as we told you at the outset, it became a sport of friends. Didn't matter what team you were with, you were part of the Earnhardt team. It's an amazing sport. Let's go to Mike Joy.
Ken, perhaps he doesn't race for the money, but Dale Earnhardt and Richard Childress will take a check to the bank in total of $1,059,000. We had a lot of firsts today. We also had a few seconds. Mr. Baker, your record's intact.
I was wondering there for a little while. I was just glad no one was injured today. Good safe race, and Dale Earnhardt set history right where he wanted to. He's done it all now.
Second fastest Daytona 500 ever, Buddy Baker has still won the fastest.
And at 46, Dale Earnhardt became the second oldest driver to win the Daytona 500. Bobby Allison holds that distinction. He was 50 when he won it back in 1988.
He may not have started the day as everybody's choice to win, but if your favorite driver couldn't, I'll bet you're glad to see Dale Earnhardt celebrating finally in victory lane. We'll be right back.
Every day, the world wakes up eager to run. And that's exactly the way it should be.
Do you see the stars?
Everything you do.
Can you see the stars?
Everywhere you go. A world so vast. A world so free.
Mexico, a world of energy.
Last weekend, Beth took her Ford ZX2 out for a little adventure.
You know that van is still following us?
And she found it.
Let's lose them. Yeah.
Of course, the ZX2 makes a perfect getaway car. As long as you know who you're getting away from. Oh, well. Hey, she would have hated having a chauffeur anyway. Ford Escort ZX2, built to last.
Screaming, pointing, and praying are all acceptable ways for a NASCAR fan to show their support. Now, there's another. Drink accordingly.
You're not the only one who depends on good brakes. With our upfront pricing policy at Midas, you only pay for the brake repairs you approve.
In celebration of NASCAR's 50th anniversary, CBS Sports coverage of the Daytona 500 is sponsored by Wrangler. Real, comfortable jeans. Coca-Cola Classic. Always the real thing. Always Coca-Cola. And by First Plus Financial. At First Plus, we're working first for you.
Celebration continues here at Daytona. Crowd beginning to get out of that grandstand. All of these grandstands. Biggest crowd ever to see this event. Down here in Victory Lane, they're still coming up with extra prizes for the guy who'd won today, Dale Earnhardt. We have an update from the Olympics coming up for you from the Winter Olympic Games, and we'll go there and then return once again to Daytona and with a story here at this hour.
Well, quite a scene down in Daytona. Welcome to Nagano, everyone, and our continuing coverage of the 18th Olympic Winter Games.